country are guided by the media and our politicians. They take these polarizing, anything that's polarizing,
right,
to pick a side.
Right.
And they have chosen Islam and Muslims as a scapegoat in this new election. It's all over everything. They've chosen it as a way to polarize. Listen, our country operates off of fear.
Yes.
It's
fear
sure
of the economy crashing.
Yes.
Fear of death, fear of disease. So now, hear what happens. Every single story they can to get an eyeball on a TV set, like you said earlier, is about some wayward Muslim who is in a sect.
Right.
Who has taken this beautiful faith and twisted it. Because nowhere in the Quran does it say to do any of this stuff. It don't say shoot nobody. It don't say crash no plane. It don't say nothing.
Well, what a lot of people don't know, Steve, is that historically, Islam kind of led in, when it came to women's inheritance rights. It established some of the world's first universities. As a Jew, Muslim nations took us in when we were expelled from Christian nations, like Spain in 1492. As a Jew, Muslim nations took us in when we were expelled from Christian nations, like Spain in 1492.